Most of us in the UK are part of families who have fought in wars. 100 years ago, millions of people,
our great-great-grandparents, they went off
to fight in World War I. But what's it like being part of a frontline family today?
You learn about war in school and in history, but for me, it's real life.
When my dad came out of the army, he used to scream in his sleep and shout, and we used to get really scared of him.
I'm really proud of him, and I'm really happy that he's coming home.
My best friend is a soldier, and I can remember him telling me that he was going to fight in Afghanistan. I was really, really proud. But then I started to think about it. Was he going to get hurt? Was he putting his life at risk? Thankfully, my friend came back safe and well, but others didn't.
Nathaniel's family has a long tradition of being in the military. Going all the way back to his great-grandfather, his family have served in the Army and Navy. It's always been Nathaniel's ambition to be a soldier. In 2010, his brother Ashley went to Afghanistan. This is him filming his work, which was clearing bombs hidden in the ground, called IEDs.
Give you a big bang in a minute.
Yeah, all right.
My brother, he was searching for IEDs and he was going along a bridge and he stood on one and got blown up. We got to see him in intensive care. I remember walking in and just thinking it was all a bad dream and that I'd wake up soon, but it wasn't. And it just kicked in. It was really emotional. I just wouldn't believe that he was there, like my brother laying in a coma. It's unbearable when you walk in there and see him. It didn't look like he was going to make it at all. I don't understand why we went into Afghan, because so many people have either died or been injured out there. I don't understand why we had to go over there in the first place. My dad was tickling him, but he was going round and round in a circle like the teddy bear, and went up his arm. My brother just threw his arm out and hit my dad. That's when I knew that he was going to make it through and that he wasn't going to die. When he's by himself, when he thinks that no one can see, he's like pretty down. Normally like make a fool out myself just to make him laugh a little bit, but if you try cheering him up, he'll just tell you to go away. After a few weeks, you're still wondering, like, is he still my brother? Like, because he's changed quite a lot. But after like a few like years that I've had, like 3 years, you get used to it. He's changed quite a lot, but the best bits about him are, like, still exactly the same. Like, he's just my brother. He's amazing. I just love him to bits.
What happened to Nathaniel's brother is known as a physical injury. But for some soldiers, their injuries aren't always as easy to see. 13-year-old Ellie's dad suffers from a condition known as post-traumatic stress disorder, or PTSD, which means he's been damaged by the stress he's caused by fighting in war zones. Even now, years after leaving the army, his PTSD still affects his behaviour.
Before my dad went to war, he was more like more a person. Like, he would walk down the street and he'd have a smile on his face and, like, he'd have the kind of cuddliness in him, and it's unbelievable, like, him, like, changing, like, so quickly. You can't really see any physical injuries on my dad, but he does suffer with mind injuries because of what he's been through in the war. When he came back from the army, I found it hard to cope because every time there was a loud noise or like the wind or anything like that, like they'd like shut the doors through the house, there was a window open, like he pulled me under the table one time and said like take cover because the door banged and it made a loud noise like a bomb. He used to have a lot of nightmares. He's seen his mates just get shot at and he didn't like it at all. He used to scream in his sleep and shout. I'd just wake up and think, all right, my dad's a freak. He found a way of coping with it and it was to put a war film on or a loud film. And he would have to sleep with the film on so he could feel like he was in that atmosphere again. I think the thing what I struggled with was that he wouldn't sit there and talk to me about it. And like he doesn't really show emotions. He never cries. His saying is the weak only cry. Since he's been getting help and like with the doctors and like sorting his medication now, everything's going all right. If I have a problem now, I'd go and talk to him to make him feel better. And like we always have like a joke or something like that. Like I'm his little Ellie Belly.
Rebuilding family life after someone's been injured can be tough, but for some children, their family will never be the same again. Molly's dad went to Afghanistan when she was 11.
We used to play in the garden like football and cricket, and he used to go out in his sports car and have the roof down and then sing really loud. I understood that it was a dangerous job, but I never really understood how dangerous. He came back all the times before. He's good at his job, so I thought it'd be okay. I was in the playground and my teacher came to get me and she was like, "You need to go see the head teacher." She's like, "You're not in trouble though." So I thought, oh, this is really weird. And so I went to the head teacher's office and my mum was sat in there. And instantly I did have a feeling of like, dad. My head teacher left the room, so it's just me and my mum in there, and I thought something's not right. And then she just said it how it was, like she said, "Your dad's being killed in Afghanistan." And obviously I cried a lot, and then it didn't feel real, like to me there's no proof yet. So I was like, no, that's not true, but yeah. I got angry. I got angry at the fact that it wasn't fair. I was angry that it was only him. And I was angry, and the person that he was with got shot in the leg, but he was the only one that died. But he volunteered himself to go do this job, and he got awarded the Conspicuous Gallantry Cross. Me, Mum and Heather went up to London to go get the medal, and we got given it by the Queen. What he did was really great, and I guess it would be even greater if he came back, but everything, I miss everything. I definitely miss how our family's changed, how our family's not really the same family as it was. But he's still my dad. I still feel close to him. Friends don't understand because they don't, but my friends are really good at trying to understand, which is really good. And they always manage to make me feel so much better. So whatever they're doing it well.
The war in Afghanistan has been going on since 2001, but by the end of this year, we'll see all British soldiers leave the country. Children all over the UK are just waiting for that homecoming day. Cameron is 9, and for most of his life, his dad has been flying planes for the RAF, often spending months away from home. But that's all about to change.
My dad is in the RAF and he's in Afghanistan right now. It is quite dangerous up there. Yeah, I'm worried about him being away in there because I'm just worried that he might crash or something. And I really don't want that to happen. He went away quite a lot when I was born and he missed my first birthday and he's missed my sister's first birthday this year. When people like come to school, I see their dads and I just feel really sad because my dad's not here. I just miss him really so much when he goes away. Just knowing that there's one less person in the house. So I do sort of wish that he was here.
I think anyone that can go out there and try and fight for their own country deserves anything, but they don't deserve to suffer, and that's what my dad did.
I'm proud my dad died doing something that saved many others because I would never want them to go through what I went through and me and my family went through. I'd never wish it upon anyone.
I still want to join the army, but I will always know that there's a risk of getting injured or even dying. To save millions of people for one death is worth it.
If you'd like advice on any of the issues raised in this programme, you can visit the CBBC Bugbears page, where you'll find telephone numbers and websites for organisations who can help.
Introducing three new faces to CBBC: Betsy, Biscuit and Bonzo.
I just love food. I love it. Oh.
Follow the first 8 weeks of their lives as they grow.
Not that I'm like you.
Learn how to make friends.
Eat my paws, milk face.
And start to sniff out trouble.
Oh, that is well itchy, that is.
Oh, no, I got it now. Oh, oh.
Meet the Pups, a brand new series, weekdays at 7:30.